To get the orb back, you travel to Ghost Ship Cove, a known pirate hideout. As you leave the temple, a ragged old man's his rasp. You can give him a call. He does. You probably. The side of the cave connects to a fissure on the coastline. It seems large enough to contain another ocean. Sailors dread passing through this area. There are myriad tales of ships disappearing here.
It's my turn. Done.
A beautiful voice in the sea calls out to you. You'd heard of Mermaid's legendary curiosity. She asks you many questions. From your conversation, you learn Gustav's ship was indeed attacked by pirates. That means the pirates likely have the orb. According to the mermaid, the pirates scattered throughout the islands used this area as a hub for trade amongst themselves. Enemy. Rumors claim that among their treasures is a magic lamp that can call forth a demon. They were being duplicitous. It was all a ruse. The pirates were spying on you the entire time.
Come on. ambush.
You waltz right into the pirate's den. They're coming to attack you. The pirates have the magic lamp. Your situation will turn quite dire if you don't take it from them. The pirate has called the genie out. Quick, get the lamp out of the pirate's hands. The pirate has called the genie out. Quick, get the lamp out of the pirate's hands. Magic lamp granted a wish and flew off. You find the orb stolen by the Prime Minister among the treasure the pirates left behind. You reclaim the stolen royal orb. The orb you retrieved must be returned to the castle.
Welcome to my shop. What would you like?
Wandering one, how can I help you?
As you leave the temple, is
you can give him.
Wandering one, how can I help you? May they rest in peace.
As you leave the temple, is raspy.
You can give him a call.
Okay. I won't be defeated.
The princess and count can't contain their surprise. They'd already resigned themselves to the worst possible outcome. You've won a great deal of favor from the royal family. The princess smiles upon you, and Dean trusts you implicitly. The succession imbroglio has been dealt with. Once the king is buried and Parliament approves, Dean will... Still, the future king wears a somber expression. He knows Hydland still faces the Shinyak Orc tribe also, while Hydland is worse still. You are beginning to grasp why the... I need it, Dean. After completing a large task, you return to a normal routine, fulfilling requests on behalf of the Adventurers Guild.
Oh, how can I help you?
Whilst reviewing the outstanding requests at the guild, it is about rune magic. But since you don't know too much about the subject, you're not... You tell the guildmaster, Samuel, that you'll accept this job.
You're back. You have a request.
You entered Lucane's tower to ask about his request. When you tell him that you have taken on his request, he immediately starts filling you in on the details. Certain Elysian ruins are highly regarded as a sacred area by monks. Unfortunately, monsters are desecrating these. Monks were dispatched to purify the area, but the golems that used to protect the ruins have. Golems are controlled with. So Lucane requested that someone go in his stead and use rune magic to craft golems. Do you comprehend how runes work? Lucane says that he would be delighted to discuss this and launches headlong into a Runes are magical letters that spirits and fairies. Touching runes makes letters sparkle and float. Runes are a combination of three. However, runes won't work unless a spirit or fairy is present. That's what you gather from Lucane's. Lucane hands you a stone that has a rune. Activate the two runes on the statue, then add the stone's rune to cast the. You press forward and begin looking for runes.
Oh, how can I help you? Which one?
You head to the ancient temple ruins at Lucane's behest. There, you need to animate statues using rune magic.
You're back.
This underground labyrinth is said to have been made in a single night with powerful magic. It is a dangerous place, replete with traps. It bars entry to all who would dare.
Ah! It's my turn. Done. Let's see. Voila!
The trap was sprung, and the door magically closed fast. Slime creatures are weak against fire. The torch on the wall could be used to great effect. The clink of metal hitting the ground can be heard. A magic key to open the door.
Done. Oh, yes. Oh, yeah.
It's my turn. Simple.
Turning into cocoons. You must destroy the cocoons before they hatch into beetles. Fungi-infested underground labyrinth.
You're back.
Welcome to my shop. What would you like?